Hello viewers, I am Rakib. In this lesson I will show you how you can select different colors and apply them using paint bucket or gradient tool within Photoshop. So here you can see the foreground color selector and the background color selector. You can click here once to change this to set this foreground color. Let's say we want this color, and when selected we will click OK. Now we have this color selected as a foreground color. And if you want to change this background color, then you can click here as well and choose a color for the background. So the foreground and background colors are selected, and now if you click the paint bucket tool, just clicking and holding from the mouse and selecting this paint bucket tool, and if you click here once, then you will see it's painted with the foreground color. You can swap this colors with this icon clicking here. Now you can see the foreground and background colors are swapped, and you can now if you click here for a new layer and click once more, then you can see it's painted with the current foreground color. So this is one way of selecting colors. You can also select colors by the swatches palette, which is here. You can just click any of this swatches to select that as a foreground. If you can't find the swatches here, then you can go to window swatches, then you will be able to see this. And let's say we have clicked any of this color swatch, and that one is selected here, and now we can create another layer and click here to paint the layer with that color. So that's how you can use the swatches. In some cases you may have provided a color code and you want to apply it on your design. So how can you do that? Let's see. Here is a website which is color-hex.com. Here you can find different color swatches. If you like any of them, you just select this color codes and you can click copy and go to your foreground color, click here, and you can paste it, the color code. And make sure you remove this hash, because the hash is already set here. So you can just paste the color codes here, then you can click OK. So you can see that the color is selected in the foreground color figure. So if you create another layer and then paint it, then you can see you have applied that specific color swatch. You can also keep it for future use if you want. Whenever it's set as the foreground color, you can click here. You can also rename it if you want. I'll keep it as swatch 1 and we'll click OK. Then you can see that swatch is here. And also whenever you want, you can delete it as well. Just click and drag it and drop it into this icon, and that one will be gone like this. Again, in some other cases you may have any existing image, and then you want to sample any color from here and you want to apply it on your design. Then you can also do that by just when the paint bucket tool is selected, you can press and hold the alt button from your keyboard, then this eyedropper tool will be selected. You will be able to see this eyedropper, and you can pick your color from any of these areas like this or here or another part. So wherever you will click, you will get a sample color from that part. and that one will be selected as a foreground color. And now if you go to the previous document and create another layer and paint it with the paint bucket, then you can see that color is painted in the new layer. So that's how you can sample color from an existing image and apply them in your design. So these were for the solid colors. Let's work with the gradients instead of this solid colors. To apply a gradient, you have to select the gradient tool, which is here, and then you have to click here. These are some presets. You can see how it will appear in your design. You can click any of this and then click outside, and you can click here, and then you can customize it as you want. Let's click here, and you can select another color for this one. Let's say we want this color, and double click here to get another color for here, like this. You can also customize it with this slider, changing its position like this. Also you can change the midpoint like this. You can also add some other colors. If you click here and press and hold Alt from your keyboard and drag it like this, then you can see you have got another color the same as here. Then you can also do it with this one like this. So whenever you think it's done, then you can just click OK, and now you have to apply it. The setup is completed, which is here. You can see the preview. And if you create another layer and hold shift from your keyboard and drag like this, then you can see the gradients in your layer. You can drag it anyhow you want within this canvas. Dragging differently will provide you different results, and there is some more options which are here. You can pick the radial gradient, which is this, and also there are some other options. You can select and apply them and see how it looks like. So these are very static example. Let's say we have a Photoshop document and we want to apply it here. So this one is the background behind the text. We want to apply gradient within this green background. So to do that, we have to select the gradient tool from here, and we'll click here and choose any of the one. Let's choose this one and click here. You can choose any colors from here as well. Just click here once and select any color from here like this. Let's choose a color for this one. Let's pick this one. Let's say this is our setup. We want this one to apply in our design. We'll click OK, and if we drag like before, then it will be applied in your entire canvas, but we want to apply it just within this specific layer. So we will just hold Alt from our keyboard and click once, and that will allow us to select the specific layer areas. So if now we create another layer and drag holding the shift button from our keyboard, and that gradient will be applied in our design. So let's choose some other different gradient option. This one is not what I wanted. Let's select a linear gradient and drag once more. You can press Ctrl D from your keyboard, that will deselect, and I think that's pretty good. That's how you can apply solid colors using the paint bucket tool and the gradients with the gradient tool in your design. So that's it for this lesson. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you guys in the next lessons. Thank you.